Shoulders, a lot of uncertainty happening in your life. maybe a lot of doubt, maybe a lot of suffering. But the beautiful thing is that in every walk that we're coming from tonight, we are all united under one God tonight. So for the next hour and a half, let God be the center of all of us, uniting our voices, our minds, and our hearts. Let us fix our eyes on a new horizon to the way, the truth, the life who is our God. Amen. there in the shadows of this life, your great grace. It's there on the mountaintop, there in the everyday and the mundane, there in the sorrow and the dancing, your great grace, oh such grace. With us in every trial and every victory. Your grace is there even when we feel like you're not. Your grace is there whenever we pray and we feel like we don't hear you. Your grace is there in our hope. Your grace is there in the uncertainty. Your grace is there in every tear. Your grace is there in every smile. Lord, we pray that your grace continues to surround us, that it fills our hearts, and that it overflows with each and every one of us, so that when we go from here, Lord, your grace can be known in every corner of the world. Oh, falling down in worship, sing the song of ages so loud. And all that have gone before us, and all who will believe, will sing the song of ages so loud. Cause your name is the highest, your name is the greatest, your name stands above them all. And all thrones and dominions, all vows and positions, your name stands above them all. And the angels cry,
thrones and dominions, all vows and positions, your name stands above. anxious person, and in these moments of anxiety, I found myself feeling so lost and unsure of where to turn. And in an effort to calm that anxiety, I found myself sitting in one of the adoration chapels at the Norberton Abbey and began to pray, and this is the song that came from that. For me, Mass and adoration has become time that I look forward to, knowing that at least for that time, all my anxieties go away. And I'd like to leave you with words from Father Emmanuel that he shared with us this past weekend. He said, "He sees you, he hears you, and he is waiting for the appropriate time. He sees your pain, he hears your cry. God's blessing will come at the appropriate time."
Sundays, 'cause it calms me.
friend to get on the stage. Please welcome Chris Carter.
You are forever.
a lot of us might have heard that sometimes in our life, we're just not grateful enough. I think I tell my kids sometimes that they're not grateful enough. I know my parents told me I wasn't grateful enough too. You probably can relate. You know, when things are going great, things are going our way, it's so easy to praise, give thanks, sing an Alleluia, right? When you feel like your prayers are being heard, they're being answered. But what about the other way? When it's not going your way? And you got some bad news at the doctor's. Maybe something's happening at work. Maybe something's happening in your family, in your relationships. And you cry out to God for resolution, for peace. Are you still singing an Alleluia then? It's a little harder. You know, sometimes despair is knocking at our door so much. It feels like all we have left sometimes is an Alleluia. In the gospel, not this weekend, but the gospel last weekend, you may recall the story of the Canaanite woman who came to Jesus and said, "Lord, save my daughter. She's been possessed by a demon." Think, oh yeah, sure, right? God has the power to heal, right? Jesus has the power to heal, but no. Fortunately, she wasn't granted right away. In fact, she pleaded at least maybe three more times, even was told by the disciples to move along. Even Jesus telling her, you need to save the food for the children and not for the dogs. And yet she persisted. What courage and what faith to constantly be denied or feel like you're denied? How many times does that happen in our lives? Where we feel like we're praying and God just stays silent? God says, not right now. Can we have the same faith as that woman? Who eventually Jesus said, "Great is your faith." And her prayers were answered. And maybe sometimes that's what's happening. I think a lot of times that's what's happening. So in those times, can we still have an Alleluia? Even from the depths of our heart, if that's all that's left. Now, if you're here tonight and that's in that place with unanswered prayers, maybe despair is creeping in. I pray that with this song tonight, that Alleluia that you might have left, that's all you have left, and you just lift it up to God. Because even in the silence, He's still there. Even when it feels like He's saying, not yet, He's still calling you to have faith. So may we have that same faith as that Canaanite woman did. So that one day, Jesus may proclaim to us how great is our faith. And that we may draw closer to Him through that trial.
Every song must Thank you.
this opportunity, for this moment that we have this evening. We thank you, Lord, for bringing us all here together to pray together and to praise your name. We thank you, Lord, for all the help that you have given us, that even despite that we turn our backs on you, turn our backs on you, you died on the cross for us so that we may have that chance and live with you in heaven. We're demonstrating that greatest love of all, which is giving your life for us.
Sing with me. You don't withhold. Oh,
gave your life for mine. And then to the cross you crucified. All my sin and shame, it was washed by your mercy. So you are the treasure I find, my reason for living, so let my life become an offering to the one who is worthy. All praise to the Lord Most High, all praise to the one who saved.
Be the song I sing.
Bride Melissa, I came to sing with us for this lesson. So come on.
Thank you.
So while she comes up and gets set up, of course, so much to be thankful for. First and foremost, thankful to to Almighty God for this opportunity and this blessing to be together and pray tonight. Amen. I want to thank, I remember your name this year, Sister Lupita. Monsignor Borges, for allowing us to use this space tonight. Thank all of our local vendors today. Lila takes the cake back there in the pop-up truck out there. Thank you for supporting them today, and thank you for being here with us tonight. Let me just introduce you to the band real quick. Right here to your left is Rachael Baca on the piano. Here to your right on the violin and vocals is Chris Charters. My name is Simon Gerard. And the man who's been always had this visionary for doing these kinds of things and continuing this ministry, along with Selena back there as well, that Father Graham started. Rest in peace, Father Graham. Our dear friend and brother in Christ here, Carlo de la Cruz. So as we wrap this up tonight, thank you all so much for coming and praying with us tonight. God willing, we get to do this again next year. We'll come back together. So from here, I pray that in this last song that we go forth from here remembering that our God is still with us, even in the times that when we step out those doors it may look like and feel like he's not. He is still with us, and he's calling us to be that light in the world that and that darkness that's continuing to creep up. And we can continue to do that as long as we keep leaning on him and his promises. Amen.
Amen.
Maybe we should stand up for this last one. Good night.